In this video, we'll look at Maya's projects, scenes, and preferences, basically what you need to know to get set up. In Softimage, projects are databases where you store all the stuff you need for your work: scenes, materials, textures, scripts, presets, and so on. In Maya, projects are very similar for storing the data you need to work. Unlike Softimage, you don't need to first create a project before you can save a scene file in Maya because there's a default project set up for you. That being said, it's always a good idea to create your own project before you start any serious work. To do this, choose File Project Window, then click the New button. This creates a project folder with all these subfolders in it. The primary locations are obviously the folders you want to access all the time, but you can also set up folders in the Secondary, Translators, and Custom Data divisions. The locations for these subfolders are usually within the root directory of the project. But folders can also be in external locations, like on a server, which is handy when you're sharing data with your team. Like Softimage, Maya uses the idea of a current project. This is especially useful since scene folders can be anywhere, and Maya stores all paths relative to the project folder. If you want to set a different project as current, choose File, Set Project, and select it. If you already have a scene loaded from another project and save it, it still gets saved in its original location. But you can easily save it into the current project if you like. As with Softimage, opening data files is automatically done from the current project. You can also select a project that will load by default when you open Maya. To do this, choose Window, Settings/Preferences, Preferences, to open the, no surprise here, Preferences window. Select Files/Projects, then select the default project you want in the project settings, and click Save. What makes a Maya project a project, and not just some ordinary folder, is the very important project definition file called workspace.mel. It's created when you save a project and is stored in the project's root directory. This file contains the names and locations of all the folders in your project. It's automatically updated whenever you change folder locations in the project window. But if you change folder names and move them otherwise, you'll need to make sure to update this file. If you have unresolved paths for external data, you can use the File Path Editor to diagnose and fix these paths. This includes paths for textures, audio, references, image planes, and scene assembly files. For more information on creating a project and best practices for projects, see the video Setting a Maya Project on the Maya Learning channel. Scenes in Maya are pretty much the same thing as they are in Softimage. They contain all the elements that you need for working and composing your art, such as objects, cameras, lights, and so on. You can save scene files in Maya as either binary or ASCII, but typically you save scene files in binary, .mb files, which are smaller. Maya ASCII files, .ma files, are editable and human-readable, and often used for things like file references. You can set up auto-saving for your scenes as you can with Softimage, which is not on by default in Maya. In the Preferences window, select Files/Projects. Then under Auto-Save, select Enable, and set up the options as you like. Another preference you might find useful is Ignore Version, which lets you easily load up scene files from older versions of Maya without needing to edit them first. This option also lets you load scene files from newer versions of Maya, such as 2015, into an older version, such as 2014, but you might get some errors because of feature incompatibility between the versions. You can save different versions of the same scene file, which is similar to the backup iterations you can save for scene files in Softimage. To do this, choose File, Increment, and Save, which saves the current scene with an incremented number appended to its name, such as playroom.001.mb. In Softimage, you can merge other scenes into your current one, which is a handy way of bringing in complete scenes without having to import the objects separately. In Maya, you can do the same thing as merging, but it's called importing. Choose File Import and select the scene you want to bring in, and set the options you want on the right. This includes keeping the namespace of the scene so that the new objects don't override existing objects with the same name. This is the same way in which scenes are merged as models in Softimage to keep their namespace. Let's move on to customizing Maya with preferences. Just as Softimage has seemingly countless preferences, so does Maya, a few of which you've already seen. In Maya, you can find most preferences in the Preferences window. For example, if you miss that familiar gray of the Softimage background, you can select Display and set a preference to turn off the background gradient. And if the view cube is visible with certain renderers, you can easily hide it. There's even a preference to save all preferences and settings or not when you close Maya. There are other specific preferences in this menu, such as for tools, performance, hotkeys, and so on. For example, in the color settings, you can change the default background color if you don't have the gradient on, or you can set the two gradient colors to what you want. From here, you can also set the colors used anywhere else within Maya. Another way of setting up preferences and options for a specific command is to click the little box that is beside many of them. For example, if you click the Options box beside File, New Scene, you can set up the default working units that will be used for all new scenes. Or even enable a default scene to be used when you create a new scene, like a template. This is the same as setting the preferences of the same name in the Preferences window, such as the ones under Settings in this case. To get back to the default settings in the Option boxes, choose Edit, Reset Settings. Speaking of working units, there are a few preferences that you should set up before you start working in Maya, such as the scene units. In Softimage, the infamous Softimage unit was whatever you needed it to be, with just a few Newtonian restrictions for physics simulations and a general rule of thumb of not making objects too small. In Maya, actual units of measurement are used, such as centimeters, which is the default, meters, inches, and so on. When you open other scenes or import files from other products, make sure to check the units that they use. Another thing you should set before you start working is the frame rate, which is shown in the time list here. In Maya, it's set to 24 frames per second for film by default, but you can change it to whatever you like. The world coordinate system for scenes has Y as the up axis by default, just like Softimage. But if you're working with scenes from 3ds Max, for example, you could change this to Z. You might also want to set the number of undo operations to a certain queue size before you start working. There are obviously many other preferences to set, but we'll look at them in context as we go. When you save your preference settings, it updates the appropriate preference file in the Prefs folder in Maya's install path. For example, when you click Save in the Preferences window, the userprefs.mel file is updated. If you've made changes to the Maya layout, hotkeys, colors, marking menus, and options in the Preferences window, you can save everything in one shot by choosing File, Save Preferences. Doing this updates all the prefs files. These settings are then used instead of Maya's default factory settings. But if you want to get back to the default factory settings, you can rename or delete one or all of the prefs files or the whole prefs folder. Then the next time you open Maya, it will prompt you to create default preferences or copy from your old preferences. Just to know, this is a common remedy for when you're getting unexpected behavior or errors in Maya. So that's just a first step to crossing the bridge from Softimage to Maya. In the next video, we'll look at Maya's dependency graph, which is a key concept you should understand before going further.